The invert effect is found under the channel category, and when you apply it to your layer, it defaults to inverting the colors, the RGB channel. And we can choose to blend that with the original if you wanted to animate it or only invert it partially for some reason, you can do that. But what's great is that you can invert a number of channels in the channel dropdown. If we only wanted to invert the red channel, the green, or the blue, we could do that. Hue, lightness, saturation, or each one individually. There are many options in here, but the last one is worth noting because you can actually invert the alpha channel. And since my logo has transparency, it inverts that channel, and now I'm left with something that looks a little bit more like a stencil. So invert is a very specific effect, but I do find myself using it quite a bit in my own workflow. Hey, thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this tutorial, then check out the other ones here on my YouTube channel. And if you like my teaching style, then definitely check out my longer form content on Skillshare and School of Motion. And if you want to support more tutorials like this one, check out my Patreon. You can find links for all of that stuff in the description of this video.